so it took a while to get here, but you know, once we got here, it was like, this is Africa.
I wanted to do something. You know, I feel like I have so much. I've been gifted with so much that it's kind of an obligation for me, in my mind, to actually help other people. Kenya was on the top of the list for World Vision as a needy place to really, the money would go really far. Like, if you invest with these guys, it's gonna create a lot of difference really fast.
These are our brothers and sisters, and this is what they're living in. And you know, if you have it in your heart, there's so much we can do, and it's such a great feeling. You know, not only is the need there, but as human beings, when we become a part of that helping process, it changes all of us. And oh my God, did it.
So yesterday was our first day out in the field, seeing the community, and we visited our first school.
I didn't really have a notion of what it was gonna be like. I'm like, yeah, we're going to school, they have a day off, we don't know how many kids are gonna show up, like, don't expect much. And we show up and you just hear in the distance like this slow chant. And you're like, oh wait, turn down the music in the car, like, what is that? And you just, it gets louder and louder, and you just roll in, there's all these kids just singing and clapping, like, whoa! 650, like the whole school showed up, all walked there because they knew we were coming, and get out of the car and they're just overwhelmingly singing the most beautiful song you've ever heard.
Hannah.
700 kids are singing for us.
There's so much disease. There's diseases that we never deal with here. All the intestinal, you know, all the things that you see on like the National Geographic shows and stuff. They've lived this for generations because it's all they have.
I mean, I've never met someone with AIDS in my life, and the first person I meet over there is this little 8-year-old boy.
Nelson, that was another part of seeing the face of AIDS over there.
Wow, like you don't even know what to do or say.
So Grandma, she's probably maybe 60.
She was just explaining how they struggle and how she makes less than a dollar every couple of days.
There's so many stories in the US about the AIDS epidemic, but to go in and experience it and to see what these people are living through and the tragedy.
Like, you don't even know what to do or say, but to treat them normal, obviously, but it's like you just want to give them the world.
Growing up in America for 21 years and then coming here and seeing the difference in mindsets and how the material things don't matter here. Like, these people don't have TVs or video games.
Seeing what Hannah has done over here has been mind-blowing.
When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag.
This is better than 20 Olympic gold medals.
When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. And then it goes back, and then it goes back, and then it goes back. Oh.
Born to a throne, stronger than Rome, but violent prone, poor people's own. But it's my home, all I have known, where I got grown, streets we would roam. Out of the darkness, I came the farthest, among the hardest survivors. Learn from these streets, it can be bleak, accept no defeat, surrender, retreat.
So we struggling,
fighting to eat,
and we wondering
when we'll be free. So we patiently wait for that fateful day. It's not far away, but for now we say,
when I get older.
We can learn so much from them and how little they have, but how grateful they are for what they have.
And then it goes back, and then it goes back.